Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a nice and simple portrait photo slideshow animation inside of Adobe After Effects, which is absolutely easy to create because I will guide you through each and every step. So this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open Adobe After Effects and get started. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, the all new version 2025. Let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition. This is going to be our main composition. You can also call it render comp. Set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution. Frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color black, and then hit OK. And this is our main composition. And now let's create one more composition, that is going to be our media placeholder, where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So it's very simple. Just go to composition again, click on new composition. This is going to be media 01. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now let's import an image or video file that we want to use in this project. So just go to project window, right click on that, import file, and select an image. So in this case, I am using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com. You can import any image that you like. Select that image, click on import. Let's rename this image. So just right click on that, click on rename, call it image 01. Perfect. Now let's drag and drop the image inside of this media composition, and after that we have to fit the image inside of this media composition. So hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it up just a little bit and fit the image. Hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key and move it just like this. All right, and then just go to render composition. This is our media 01. Drag and drop inside of this main composition. And then we have to animate the image. So just go to the end of this animation. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the value 125%. And after that, we will get this zoom out animation. Now let's apply some effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for tint effect. So this is the tint. Drag and drop this effect on this image and make it black and white. And then we have to apply one more effect. I'm gonna search for lens. So this is the camera lens blur effect. Let's apply this effect on this image. And here we have the blur radius. I'm going to use this value 5, which is absolutely perfect. After that, we have to create a new background layer. So either you can right click over here, go to new and take a new solid, or you can just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid. This is going to be our background. So I'm going to call it BZ. Select the color pure white, which is very important, and then hit OK. This is the background. Place the background below this media 1 composition. After that, we need to import an ink splash video clip. So just go to project window. You can click 2 times over here and open this window. Here we have to select this ink splash video clip that I have downloaded from mixkit.com, and I will give you a link in the description for this so you can download this video clip. Select that video clip, click on import, and this is the ink splash. Right click on that, click on rename, call it ink splash. Drag and drop this video clip inside of this main composition over on this media 01. Go to blending mode and select this option screen. Now you will get something like this right over here. You can select the preview resolution. Here we have all the options. You can select the auto. Now let's create portrait animated image. So what we have to do, this is the media 01. Select that composition, hit Ctrl D to create a duplicate. Open it up, and here we have the image. Let's change the composition size first. So hit Ctrl K on the keyboard to open this composition setting, or you can also just go to composition, click on composition setting, And here we have to change the width and height. So I'm going to set the width value 1000, height value 1200, which is perfect proportion for portrait photos. Leave the other setting as it is, hit OK. And now this is the image. Hit S by selecting this layer. Let's down the size and fit the image inside of this portrait size composition. All right. And now just go to render composition. Here we have to create one more composition by using this media 02. It's very simple. Drag and drop this media 02 on this little composition icon over here. And now we will get another composition with all the setting from media 02. All right. Now just right click on media 03, click on rename, and this is going to be portrait. Open it up, and here we have media 02. Now let's animate the media 02. So just go to the end of this animation, select the media 02, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property and lock the position as it is. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the scale value 120%. And after that, we have to create a foreground to make this photo as a portrait photo. So just go to layer, go to new and select this option solid. I'm going to call it FG for foreground. Select the color pure white, which is very important. Hit OK. And now select the foreground layer, hold control and click two times on this rectangle icon, and we will get a new rectangular mask just like this. Here we have an option to add subtract, so I'm gonna select this option subtract. Open the mask property. This is the mask expansion. Let's set the mask expansion value in negative minus 30. And after that, select the mask one, highlight these two control points right over here, hold shift and press up arrow key and make it like this. All right. And now it's looking like a portrait photograph, as you can see. Now you can close the layer, and here we have to create a text. It's again very simple. Select the text tool, go to character and select a font style. So for this one, I'm going to use this font style lemon milk. Select the style regular. I'm going to set the font size 30 pixel, character spacing 150, color black, and then click over here and type anything, whatever you like, just like this. Select the move tool, select the text layer, go to align, click on align horizontally. And after that, you can check and set it in the center. Perfect. Now it's looking like this. After that, we have to animate this text. So just go to 3 seconds, open this text layer, click on the animate, click on the opacity. And here we have the opacity parameter. Let's set the opacity 0%. Open the range selector. This is the start. Click on the stopwatch button for the start parameter. Set the value 100. Go to 1.5 seconds, I guess, and set the start value 0. Now we have something like this, but this is very linear. Select both the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point and hold this handle, drag it on the left hand side. And now we have a smooth text animation. All right. Now you can close the layer, and here we have the portrait animation. Perfect. Just go to render composition, drag and drop the portrait into the main composition over on this ink splash layer on the top. All right. And select the portrait, hit S, set the size of the scale 75%. And after that, we have to animate this image. So what we have to do, just go to 1.5 seconds, hit P on the keyboard to open the position, lock the position value as it is by clicking on this stopwatch button. Go to very first frame. Let's drag it down. You can animate this image in any direction. Simply you can move this value in left, right, top, bottom, whatever you like. But in this case, I'm going to animate from bottom to top. All right. So that's why I have created something like this. and then just go to 4 seconds. Lock the position as it is by clicking on this diamond button. Go to the end of this animation. Let's set the value and move it in upper direction. Perfect. And here we have this type of animation, but this animation is linear. So select all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side, highlight this point, drag it on the right hand side and make a easy ease graph just like this. Close the graph editor and now you can see here we have nice and smooth animation. Perfect. After that, what we have to do, we have to add some movement over here. So hold Alt on the keyboard, click on the stopwatch button to open the expression box. Let's type an expression wiggle. This is the wiggle expression. Let's set the value 1, 10. Perfect. And now you can see here looking very organic. After that, we have to type a text over here. So what we have to do, this is the text tool, select that tool, click over here and type anything in 2 lines. Type the text like this, hit Ctrl A to highlight all and change the font style. So in this case, I'm gonna use this Bassy font style. So this is the Bassy font style. You can select any font style that you like. I'm gonna set the size value 65. Set the line spacing auto, character spacing 0. All right, and now let's break the line from maybe here. So you can type the text like this and then select the move tool and place the text right over here like this. All right, and after that we have to animate the text as well. So what we have to do, just go to 2 seconds. Hit P to open the position property, lock the position, go to 1/2 second. Let's drag the text outside of the frame in bottom direction. And we have something like this. Now just go to 3.5 seconds. Click on the diamond button to create a keyframe. Just go to the end of this animation, maybe on 5 seconds. Drag the text in upper direction. Just like this. All right, highlight all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor and create a smooth easy ease graph just like this. And here we have something like this. Now we have to do one more thing which is very important. Just go to 4.5 seconds. Open this media 01, open the opacity. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the opacity. Just go to the end of this animation. Let's set the opacity value 0. And now we have something like this. You can also add the wiggle effect on the text. So hold Alt on the keyboard. Click on the stopwatch button of the position. Let's type wiggle expression. Hit enter. Set the value 1, 5. All right. Now you can close the layer and here you can see some movement on the text. After that, let's import one more thing. Just go to project window, click 2 times here and I'm going to use this flare. I will give you a link in the description. Basically, you will get complete project file link in the description. You can download the complete project file and you will get this flare inside of that. Click on import, drag and drop the flare inside of the main composition. Let's change the blending mode to a screen and now we have the lens flare. And after that, just click on the toggle switches, turn on the motion blur for all the layers and now it is almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, set the resolution full, go to full screen and let's have a look. And finally, this is looking amazing, right? So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such videos, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and also comment below what you think about it. My name is Vikas Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.